Fan Cam is brought to you by Carl's TV and Appliance, your servicing dealer since 1956.
Madison opened its season with a 22-16 win at Dakota Valley and now stands fifth in the Class 11A Prep Media poll. Tonight, the Bulldogs attempted to hand number three Canton its second straight loss. The Bulldogs strike first off play-action quarterback Nate Rickey, rolls to his right and hits Carter Bergheim in the end zone for a touchdown. PAT is good. Madison up 7-0. Later, Canton punting in its own territory, and Madison, the special teams, make a special play. Trey Smith blocks a punt. Logan Albee falls on the ball for the touchdown. Bulldogs up 14-0. Second quarter, Madison keeps that momentum going out of the pistol. Rickey slashes his way through the Seahawk defense, gets into the open field, and he's gone. 54 yards for the touchdown. Madison leads 21-0 over the defending champs. More from the home team in the second as Rickey, looking to his left, hits Bergheim, who makes a man miss and walks into the end zone for his second touchdown. 27-0 Madison at that point. Third quarter, Seahawks looking to get on the board. Seth Peterson hands off to Luke Richardson, who muscles his way in for the touchdown, but the lead just too much to overcome. Madison knocks off Canton 34-18. On the heels of last week's win at Canton, top-ranked T-Area met Vermilion. Titans get the scoring started in the opening quarter. They give to Connor Mulder. He finds a hole and scampers in for a 15-yard touchdown. Home team on top, 7-0. 3 minutes later, Titans back on the Tanager 15. This time they feed Garrett Kolbeck. Senior gets to the far sideline and takes it in for six. PAT is good, 14-0 T-Area. Second quarter, the Titans continue to click on offense. Caden Johnson gets in the action, weaving in through the defense, finds Pater 7 yards out, making it 21-0. Titans continue to pound away on the ground. Johnson again gets the call, motors past the Vermilion defense. That's 34 yards on the touchdown run. And T-Area improves to 2-0 on the year with a 54-0 victory over Vermilion.
After opening the season with a win at Huron, Brookings played at Lennox. Bobcats break a scoreless tie on their second possession as fullback Wes Kana gets the rock and rumbles in for the 1 yard TD. Brookings up 7-0. After recovering a fumble, Brookings cashes in on the turnover as Josh Burry bounces to the outside, and it's off to the races for a 47 yard touchdown. That made it 14-0 in favor of the Bobcats. Head to the second quarter, Brookings going to go back to Burry again, and watch this run here as he's going to avoid one defender, and then he's going to avoid a couple more down the sideline. He's finally knocked out of bounds, but that has the Bobcats back in business after the 38-yard gain by Burry. Then later in the drive, facing third and goal, Burry's going to get the call again, and he'll bully his way through a couple tacklers and find his way into the end zone from 10 yards out, and Brookings shuts out Lennox 37-0. A top five contest in Class 11B featuring Sioux Valley and Bridgewater Emory Ethan. On the Cossacks' opening drive, Parker Pitts fakes the handoff, breaks the tackles, he gets to the outside and into the end zone. 6-0 Cossacks. On the Seahawks' first drive, facing third and nine, Caden Klum lobs into the back of the end zone where Jay Storm goes up for an 11-yard TD. Bridgewater takes a 7-6 lead. Second quarter, Seahawks run the old student body right. Klum on the keeper for a 2-yard score, 14-6 in favor of the visitors. And just before half, Sioux Valley facing fourth and five. Pitts rolls out, buys time. He's going to throw over a defender and connect with Damian Danzeisen, who just gets into the end zone. That made it 14-12, but Bridgewater Emory Ethan earns a 21-12 win over the Cossacks.
We'll have highlights from Del Rapids, Haywarden, and Rock Valley next. This is the Kettle Land Sports Zone.